Greetings everyone, as I have promised it, I have purchased RTX 5090 and today I am starting experimentation and benchmarking with it. I have paid $4,000, it was really expensive, but as I have promised it, I have purchased it for testing and benchmarking for you guys. So currently the GPU is mounted into my new case as you are seeing right now. This is RTX 5090 and this is my older RTX 3090 Ti. I will be doing experimentation and benchmarking with both of the GPUs. Therefore, I am keeping both of them on my case as you are seeing right now. Here you are seeing I am holding both of the GPUs. So this is RTX 3090 Ti and this is the RTX 5090. The brand I have purchased is MSI Gaming Trio Overclock Edition, as you are seeing. Here, few side-by-side comparison of RTX 5090 versus RTX 3090 Ti. Here, another view of the both GPUs. Here, another view of the both GPUs. And here, another view. So now I will begin FurMark testing. I will also do some overclocking and I will also show you the noise level of the GPU while it is running at 100% load. So let's start the FurMark. Before I run all three benchmarks, I want to show you how it looks, because when I benchmark, OBS Studio is not able to record the screen. So currently you are seeing its values. It is doing over 200 FPS usually. The average is 211 FPS. I am also recording a video, therefore it is not at its maximum performance, but this is running at 4K resolution and this is just amazing. And here let me also show you GPU Z values while it is running, while it is under load. I have done a quite long test before this video. I let it run 40 minutes and it went up to 79 Celsius with the maximum fan speed of 37%. It is just extremely silent, quiet and cool. So this GPU is just amazing. Now let me do the tests and show you the results. All right, all three tests have been completed. We got 14K score in 4K resolution. We got 23,700 score at 1440 resolution. And we got 30K score at 1080 resolution. Now I will do some overclock and repeat the experimentation. How much overclock that I'm going to do? I'm going to go with some safe values. So for memory, I am going to do 1500 megahertz and for GPU core clock, I am going to do 300. Apply and now they are applied. And I will repeat the test and show you the results. Then I will show you results of RTX 3090 Ti and then the noise levels. Okay, we got the overclocked results from 14,000 to 14,400. And this is the new score for 1440K and this is the new score for 1080. I will make a graph at the end of the video. As a next step, let me demonstrate you how to run FurMark at my second GPU, which is RTX 3090 Ti, as I have told you, and see how it performs. So to do that, I will right click and from here show more options and I will say render OpenGL on RTX 3090 Ti. And this way I will be able to use it on my second GPU, even though it shows here like this. It is not accurate. Click run. And you will see that now it is using my RTX 3090 Ti. And this is its FPS. I will run the tests on RTX 3090 Ti as well, so that we will see the score comparison. I will make a graph at the end. However, as soon as I start the benchmark on RTX 3090 Ti, I start hearing its fan noise. This is bad. You can see it is increasing the fan as any second passes. this is much more noisy than RTX 5090. I will show you also the noise comparison at the end, so keep watching. All right, I have completed testing and I have prepared a chart for you. We can see the results as like this. So these are the default clock speeds of the GPU. These are the slight overclocking that I have made. 300 plus GPU core clock and 1500 plus memory clock. So these are the three scores and these are the 3090 Ti scores. However, 3090 could be bottlenecking because of the PCI Express lane speed. Unfortunately, 3090 Ti is running only at X4, not X16. Therefore, it could be bottlenecking. So this is the chart as a table. You can see that overclock percentage is estimated based on boost clock of 2400 MHz for the RTX 5090 and 1860 MHz for the RTX 3090 Ti. So these are the overclock percentages. We can see that MSI is coming with slightly boosted clocks already, and I did more overclocking like this. However, since they are dynamic, you see they are changing according to the resolution. I also noticed that when you are at a lower resolution, it is able to run with higher base clocks compared to the higher resolution when running FurMark. Now I will run them for a while and I will show you their noise levels under load. I will run them on FurMark and I will record them with my phone and I will show you their noise level. Let's see. Alright, it has been over 17 minutes of running stress test on RTX 5090 and you see this is the noise it has because the fan speed is only at 37% and the temperatures are great. Let me show you. Currently I am running with boosted memory clock and the core clock and it has been over 18 minutes now and you see the temperature is 78 Celsius, the fan speed is only 37%, so this is great. This GPU is great, it is working great. Alright, this is RTX 3090 Ti. This is the noise that it is making. You see, even though it is outside of the case, it is still pretty loud because of the temperatures. But this is probably the cheapest RTX 3090 Ti that you can get. And here, as you can see, it has been running over 11 minutes. Its temperature is around 79 Celsius and the fan speed is 60% as you are seeing. Finally, hopefully I will be doing a lot of more tests on AI applications, on other games and other benchmarks. So keep watching, stay subscribed. I will add all of the videos into a new playlist. I will link the playlist in the description of the video so you will be able to watch all of the benchmarks, experiments, and tests I make with the RTX 5090.